Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 26th of May. Heat wave intensifies in northern India. Weather office issues red alert. Pakistan hints at re-imposing lockdown as COVID-19 cases surge past 57,000. And US hails Afghan government's pledge to release Taliban prisoners. And now for all the details. COVID-19 cases continue to surge in India, with total tally crossing 145,000 mark on Tuesday. The spike comes a day after India resumed its domestic flight services, a major relaxation under its fourth phase of nationwide lockdown.
India registered 6,535 new cases in the last 24 hours, taking the country's COVID-19 tally to 145,380 on Tuesday, the Health Ministry confirmed. This includes 80,722 active cases and 60,490 who have been treated and discharged, and 4,167 deaths. India is observing its fourth phase of nationwide lockdown until May 31st, but this time with some major relaxations, including resumption of domestic flights and reopening of several businesses. Leader of the country's main opposition Congress party on Tuesday criticized the move, saying the aim and purpose of the nationwide lockdown, which is to curb the COVID-19 spread, has failed.
We are the only country in the world where the virus is exponentially rising, and we are removing a lockdown. So it is pretty clear that the aim and the purpose of our lockdown has failed.
Meanwhile, commuters faced heavy traffic after the Ghaziabad District Administration once again sealed its border with the national capital New Delhi, citing an increase in the number of virus cases in recent days.
India is set to witness one of its toughest summers ahead. Meteorological Department has issued red alert for several parts of northern India and warned the temperatures will continue to hover near 45 degrees Celsius this week.
India is set to witness one of its toughest summers ahead, with temperatures hovering near 45 degrees Celsius in many parts of the country on Tuesday. Meteorological Department has said the temperatures are expected to rise further over the week. India is currently under a lockdown with ease restrictions to curb the coronavirus spread. However, all those who had to step out were seen with their faces and head covered to prevent heat strokes. The maximum temperature along the India-Pakistan border in the desert province of Rajasthan was recorded above 46 degrees Celsius on Monday.
लेकिन एकदम से जैसे ही वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंस मतलब वो पास ऑन हुआ है तो एकदम से जो टेम्परेचर है राइज करने शुरू कर गए हैं तो उससे सो जैसे कि कल से ज़्यादा जो टेम्परेचर 24th से हम देख रहे हैं कि टेम्परेचर ज़्यादा राइज किए हैं तो 24th टू 28th तक जो चांसेस हैं कि टेम्परेचर्स बढ़ेंगे और 47 डिग्री तक भी टेम्परेचर जा सकते हैं.
Meanwhile, huge swarms of locusts, one of the deadliest pests for farm produce, took over the skies in northern and central India, affecting agricultural lands over the past 2 days. Climate scientists say erratic weather linked to climate change has created ideal conditions for the insects to surge in numbers not seen in a quarter of a century.
In news from Pakistan, senior health official Dr. Zafar Mirza said on Monday that Pakistan's coronavirus cases and deaths were on the rise. He urged citizens to follow government-mandated standard operating procedures against the virus and warning that strict lockdowns could be reimposed if the trajectory continued. The Pakistan government would reimpose a strict lockdown in the country if violations of the safety measures against the spread of coronavirus continued. Special assistance to the Pakistan Prime Minister on Health, Dr. Zafar Mirza, said on Monday. Addressing a media briefing in Islamabad, Mirza said that the cases were rising very fast and there was more need to be careful. He asserted that the government eased lockdown before Eid, but people flouted necessary standard operating procedures or SOPs, creating fear and uncertainty. The warning by Mirza comes weeks after Pakistan had started phase-wide easing of the nationwide lockdown earlier this month.
ki pabandi nahi ki ja rahi hukumat zahir hai ki surat hal ka asar no jaiza legi aur agar zarurat samji gayi agar us pe hame SOPs ke upar pabandi hoti hui nazar na aayi to yakeenan hame apne lockdown ke faisle pe nazar sani karni padegi.
Pakistan's coronavirus cases on Tuesday reached 57,705 with 1,356 new patients, while the death toll climbed to 1,197 after 30 people lost their lives in the last 24 hours. Moving on, an opposition leader has blamed that Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has not provided any COVID-19 relief to the public in over 2 months long lockdown in the illegally occupied region.
Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf leader Syed Zeeshan Haider has blamed the Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has not provided any COVID-19 relief to the public in over 2 months long lockdown in the illegally occupied region. The opposition leader said the Prime Minister has not fulfilled any promise that he committed on the eve of election 4 years ago and continues to remain missing from his constituency amid the pandemic.
आज जब पूरी दुनिया की हुकूमतें अपने बजट को काट के अपनी तनख्वाहों को कम करके लोगों को रिलीफ पैकेजेस दे रही हैं, इस वक्त तक आज लॉकडाउन को तकरीबन 2 माह से ज़ायद का वक्त हो चुका, आज़ाद कश्मीर में किसी भी किस्म का कोई पैकेज, रिलीफ पैकेज हुकूमत आज़ाद कश्मीर की तरफ से न दिया गया.
Pakistan administered Kashmir has reported 211 confirmed COVID-19 cases and 2 deaths so far. Locals in the illegally occupied region have blamed the pandemic is acting as a salt on their wounds, as the government has continued to neglect their demands for relief and improvement in health care sector.
The United States and the Taliban had welcomed the Afghan government's pledge to release up to 2,000 Taliban prisoners as the goodwill gesture in response to the Taliban's announcement of a 3-day ceasefire for Eid.
The United States and the Taliban have welcomed the Afghan government's pledge to release up to 2,000 Taliban prisoners as a goodwill gesture in response to the Taliban's announcement on Saturday evening of a 3-day ceasefire for Eid. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani in a tweet said that the U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo phoned him and Dr. Abdullah Abdullah, the head of the High Council for National Reconciliation, and thanked the Afghan government for initiating the brave process of releasing up to 2,000 Taliban prisoners. The Afghan government on Monday released 100 Taliban prisoners as part of the 2,000 prisoners it pledged to release, informed a spokesman for the Afghan National Security Council. The Taliban has called Ghani's pledge to release 2,000 prisoners a good step, but said the process of releasing 5,000 prisoners, part of February 29 US Taliban deal, should be completed to create a suitable environment for confidence building.
Afghanistan's capital Kabul has been under lockdown to prevent the spread of the novel coronavirus. While many markets and restaurants remain closed, the kitchen of Mr. Cook, a fast food restaurant, is bustling with online orders as it is one of the few restaurants providing food delivery services to customers.
Afghanistan's capital Kabul may be in lockdown, but the kitchen is bustling at Mr. Cook, a fast food restaurant where staff are busy chopping meat and tomatoes and putting pizzas into the oven. While many markets and restaurants are closed to prevent the spread of the novel coronavirus, Mr. Cook can stay open as it is one of the few restaurants in the city and the country providing online orders and delivery to customers.
از این خاطر تفاوت پارسال تا امسال خیلی میتونه باشه به خاطر که همین یک از دلایلش همیست که شهر قرنطینه است و رستورانت هایی که مثل ما خدمات دلیوری دارن دلیوری ما نسبت پارسال خیلی بیشتر شده مخصوصا در ماه مبارک رمضان.
The restaurant has, however, not been immune to the virus's impact, as it initially had to lay off 20 staff and now operates with a total of 25. Present staff at Mr. Cook takes precautions, including wearing masks and gloves and using hand sanitizer to fight the battle against the coronavirus. Kabul, a city of 6 million, was put on lockdown on March 28 to curb the spread of the coronavirus, with offices, public transportation and most businesses closed.
In news from Nepal, Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli on Monday blamed neighbouring India for the rising number of COVID-19 cases in his country. In a televised address to the nation, Oli claimed that the unchecked flow of people from India was causing the spike in cases in Nepal.
Less than a week after his previous blame of India's role in spreading COVID-19 in the Himalayan nation, Nepalese Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli reiterated his statement while addressing the nation on Monday. In a televised address, Oli claimed that workers returning home from India who remained unchecked at border contributed in spread of the virus in the country. PM Oli's address coincided with the highest spike recorded in COVID-19 cases in his country on Monday, with total tally reaching 682 and 4 fatalities reported so far.
छिमेकी मित्र राष्ट्र भारतबाट अधिकांश घर फर्कनेहरू नियमको पालना र परीक्षण बिना नै अनेक कष्ट झेल्दै ठूलो संख्यामा सीमा पार गरिरहनु भएको छ.
Last week, Oli in a parliament session pointed to India for the spread of the virus in the Himalayan nation, adding, the strain of the virus coming from India was deadlier than the one being transmitted from China or Italy. The allegations from Oli came amid Nepal's border row with India after the construction of a key road connecting the disputed Lipu Lake Pass with Dharchula in India's Uttarakhand province.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday held a telephonic conversation with his Bangladesh counterpart Sheikh Hasina, in which they shared their assessment of the damage caused by Cyclone Amphan and discussed the COVID-19 pandemic situation and collaboration between the two countries. He conveyed greetings on Eid al-Fitr to Hasina and the people of Bangladesh. Modi reaffirmed India's support to Bangladesh in addressing these challenges. Prime Minister Modi conveyed his best wishes for the good health and well-being of Hasina and the friendly people of Bangladesh. An engineer in India's southern Coimbatore city has designed a robotic car to run errands to help maintain social distancing during the coronavirus pandemic. Social distancing still remains to be the need of the hour as multiple lockdown relaxations have been introduced and cases continue to rise. A robotic engineer, Karthik Velayutham, in India's southern Coimbatore city, has made a robot to running his errands in the market to promote social distancing in the time of a global pandemic. The little robo is catching the eyeballs for the regular market visitors as it follows all the rules while standing in queues, maintaining social distancing and also giving the message to others with posters. The shopkeepers pack the food packets according to order and keep the parcel in the robot crate. The robot then takes the parcel to the customer. They believe that if such practice is followed everywhere, then the impact of the pandemic can plummet.
பண்ணிருக்கேன் இந்த ரோபோ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா வேர்ல்டில் நீங்கள் எங்கே இருந்தாலும் கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணலாம் இன்டர்நெட் அப்புறம் வீடியோ கால் யூஸ் பண்ணி நம்ம கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணிக்கலாம் அப்புறம் இந்த ரோபோ வந்து ஷாப்பிங்க்கெலாம் யூஸ் பண்ணும்போது நம்ம சோசியல் டிஸ்டன்ஸை வந்து நம்ம மெயின்டைன் பண்ண முடியும் யார் பக்கத்துலேயும் போய் அவங்க பக்கத்தில் நின்று தான் பொருள் வாங்குறதை நம்ம வந்து அவாய்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்காக இதை பண்ணியிருக்கோம்.
Although the number of cases keeps rising, the Indian government has eased lockdown rules while asking people to wear masks and maintain social distancing. As of Tuesday, India's total number of COVID-19 cases stands at 145,380. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.